Hello everybody! As you can see, I'm playing a new game today. And my capture card is fixed, hopefully. If it's not, you wouldn't be hearing this anyway, so... it doesn't really matter to you, or for fuck does it? It took many hours of fiddling about to figure out how to fix my capture card. Just got some gunk in my throat to get rid of. Just to creep you all out a little. Right, as you can see, I've got a new game, and right at this point, that little blue thing that I just zoomed in right there, I was pretty sure that was a player. I mean, look, zooming in again, I was like, what the fuck is that shit, man? It's not. Right, so, bear in mind, I'm level 10, I think, in Gears of War, and this is the first Gears of War game I have ever played, literally ever played. I've only played it for a couple of hours in total, and I press the wrong button there. Let's get my snapper rifle out, bitch. This is an awesome... It's an awesome round. It is only one round because it's just pure awesomeness, as you can see there with a fucking no scope-ish headshot. And ooh, what's it gonna do? What's it gonna do? My loadout was the Lancer and the sawed-off shotgun. Anyway, I don't want to give any spoilers, but probably the best round I've ever played of Gears, and Gears is an incredibly hard game. I thought I would just give my little 2 cents on Gears, and I thought that was a fucking epic shot there. Some epic snipering skills going on. Gears is indeed a very good game. And there's three in a row. Woo! I just wanna get sniped for that guy sneaks up somewhere. I like the game a very lot, so the campaign, it's a little confusing considering I've never played any of the other two, so I'm like, what the fuck is going on here? I don't care if the guy's dad's dead and now he's alive and what the fuck is she? I don't know. It's all confusing, and it's just I don't really play games for campaigns anyway. It's kind of boring shooting at this big inflammable thing throwing fireballs at me for half an hour at an end, and it just will not die. That's just kind of boring in my eyes. I'd like to go and shoot it up against people. Probably will finish the campaign at some point. Just when will be the problem? Probably before Gears of War 4 comes out, which has been like 5 years time. I cannot be like fucking 2 years. Online, I think this game is awesome. It's no lag, that's unbelievable. And a little dig, I'm just going to actually grab the Gears of War case and quote you in this one, a little dig at Call of Duty. What does it say? Challenge your friends on fast and fair dedicated multiplayer service. Which is servers, which is obviously just a fucking dig at Call of Duty and their unfair ways, and I have no idea what that gun is, by the way, and the sawed-off shotgun is awesome. If you're against noobs and you can get up close next to them, like that, and just shoot them. I've really no idea what the hell this gun is. I was hoping for the little one. I don't know what it's called. Got the wee hiccups from my Indian dinner. The wee one that, like, is a laser and you aim it and then it just blows people up, because that gun's pretty goddamn awesome. There's some cunt shooting a digger at me and he misses, he fails. Right, so I just shoot this, like, oh, it'll explode. Like one shot, like, what the fuck is going on here? Nah, get rid of that crap. That's a fail with a shotgun. That sawn-off shotgun has got unbelievably bad range, but if you're standing right next to the guy, it's one shot kill, and it's pretty good if you get good at the fast switching techniques. And here's where the epicness starts. I go all out epic proness right here. I'm sorry, but I had to turn into a little camper, as you will see. There's only about, oh shit, there's 2 minutes left of this video. But it's a beast in 2 minutes by my point of view. I don't really know. I've watched one Gears video, so I'm not really too sure what's beasting and what's not, but I think this is pretty beasting. By my standards anyway, considering I've never played the goddamn game before. But yeah. Oh, and since I've never played the game before, and you lot probably have, since you're all Xbox fanboys, nothing against you, I'm probably an Xbox fanboy now anyway. I'd be really grateful if you could just give me some tips on what I'm doing wrong and what I'm doing right. I've got this bit where I'm killing people, I'm guessing that's one of the right things I'm doing. not doing many right things, but yeah, I'm guessing that's pretty much one of the right things. This is what I really love about Gears as well. You can just hide behind things and let people come to you, but it's not as if they can't really see you where you are. And it makes the game goddamn awesome. And I just go, boom, dead, son, dead. Pick your brains up off the screen. Get out, sand, it's sand. Yep, it's sand. Right now they're all just cornering me like, oh goddamn it, run away, run away. Chainsaw you in half, bitch. So you get, now here's someone with a chainsaw, I'm like, where the hell are you? I'm actually not sure what you do here. Are you actually meant to tap B? Because that's what I've been doing, so I'm guessing it's right since I killed the guy. And since you've watched my videos before, you see I've got a fail ass trigger finger, so it's a little bit hard for me. And unfortunately, that was the last kill of the game, I think. I think I just die now. I see they're all crowding around me, four people all coming at you at once. It's never good in this game. I see this guy, and I'm like, oh, I'm gonna get you with my son off. And a guy comes around the corner, and I'm like, oh, fuck, I'm gonna get you. I'm gonna get you. And then I've no idea how he managed to kill me so fast there, but anyway. So that's my impression of Gears. It's good, but to be honest, I don't think it'll last as long as Call of Duty does. Because it's just not as much customization allowable in this game. Although I do believe it is a very good game and it will definitely keep me ticking over until Modern Warfare Shitfest 3 comes out. Anyway, this has been your favouritest commentator in the whole wide world from the luxurious land that is freezing cold called Scotland. And I wish you all a happy New Year's Eve, a Merry Christmas, a sad Easter and Happy Hanukkah.